What's up, Coaster community? Millennium vs. Man back in another video. Today's video will be counting down my top 10 favorite coaster models. But before that, if you're wondering why I was quote-unquote dead for the past few days, that's because I was working on another video but had some technical troubles. So maybe I'll get those fixed up and upload that video. But for now, we have the top 10 favorite coaster models list. So anyways, let's get started with some honorable mentions. No particular order, just love these coasters, but not enough to make this list. So, B&M Flyers, Mack Hypers, B&M Gigas, Gerstlauer Infinities, GCI Woodies, Schwarzkopf Loopers, B&M Inverts, and Gravity Group Woodies. And then, to your right, we have coaster models that only I like because I'm weird. Wacky Worms, Dragon Wagons, Minor Mikes, E&F Myler Kitty Coasters, Binfari Loopers, Vekoma SLCs, Vekoma Boomerangs, and everything ever built by PAX, because PAX is GOAT. But anyways, kicking off the actual list, we got Intamin Prefabs at the number 10 spot. And even though I don't love these as much as most people, you know, still super strong airtime. El Toro, easily strongest airtime I've experienced. And, you know, some of these have very sustained airtime, strong airtime, lots of moments of airtime, whatever. You know, it's easily ejector. And airtime is the key word for all of these coasters. However, El Toro, it did feel like there wasn't really that much of anything else, and it was kind of shorter. It didn't have that many elements. And then the other ones, while they are a lot longer, their pacing is absolute trash. So they seem to not really do anything else, but since airtime is so awesome, and they offer probably the best airtime you can get on any coaster model out there, then that's why they're going to definitely find a spot on this list. Number 9, we got Intamin Accelerators, and since I love my launches, I love these Intamin Accelerators. Some of them have layouts, some of them just have an awesome launch, but I just love myself an awesome, powerful launch, and that's what these Intamin Accelerators bring to the table. Number 8, we have the RMC Topper Track Coasters, and these are the best model of wood coasters, and very similar to the hybrid coasters, however, they're just wooden instead of steel. And I've heard they're a bit rougher, and there's not as many of them. And they're not as good, but they're still awesome. Like Lightning Rod, top 20 ride, no question about it. Absolutely crazy. And then you got some other rides that don't have launches or quad downs or anything like that. Like Wildfire, and that's like the fury of RMCs, and that's not a bad thing. That's a good thing. And you also got Outlaw Run, which is short and sweet, as well as Goliath. Even though people hate on that, that's easily a top 100 ride. And all these RMC topper tracks, great pacing and great airtime. And they're a lot, like all of them are very different from each other. But yeah, they're the best wood coasters out there in my opinion. So they're going to find their way to the number 8 spot on this list. Number 7, we got the S&S Air Launch Coasters. Take everything I said about the Intamin Accelerators and crank it up to 11. You got the S&S Air Launch Coasters. Some of them have layouts, but really it's that launch that absolutely destroys everything. It is like, it's like nothing else. It's so powerful, and I am just an absolute launchaholic. So the S&S air launches, I'm gonna love those. So moving on to number 6, we got the RMC Raptors, and we've seen two of these, one under construction, or two if you count the weird one in South Dakota. But they have seriously some of the best stuff of anything. Like their pacing, it flies through the layout so fast, and you have some of the craziest airtime, even though there's like only two or three moments, and the, you know, intensity positives and like whip doesn't even look real, guys. Like these coasters just look fake. That's how good they are doing at what they do, but they are just short. They just need like 5 more elements, and then if they had 5 more elements, they'd easily, no question about it, be a top 5 coaster in the world. But for now, I like what I see in them, but they just got to be a bit longer. But for now, they do everything very well in their short track length. So if they get better pacing, or like if they get better length, and they maintain their pacing and their force strength from these originals, then we're going to be talking about some of the best coasters in the world. Number 5, we have the Intamin Blitzes, and these coasters, although they don't have as strong of launches nearly as the accelerators, they have some of them have lots of launches, and that helps them maintain their speed throughout their layout and and that is the key word, pacing. They absolutely fly. They're super low to the ground, rapid fire, flying through their layouts, and some of them might have some strong forces, others might last forever, but when you add those with the awesome pacing, yeah, you got yourself a top five coaster model. Number four, we got the Intamin Mega Coasters, or Hypers, or Mega Lights, or Gigas, but we're going to save the Gigas for later. But yeah, Intamin Mega Coasters, they come in lots of different forms. They've been around for quite a while, so there's different varieties of them, but they all at least excel in one thing, if not many things, just like Expedition G-Force you can see here. That does lots of different things, and it excels in lots of different things as well. And then Wallaby Belgium 2021 Mega, yeah, that's just going to destroy almost every single coaster out there. And you have so much more, like Skyrush, Hyperion, Superman the Ride, Goliath at Wallaby, the Ride of Steel clones, just so many to go around, and they all do at least one thing great, if not many, so that's why no matter what they do, they're going to be coming in at the number four spot. Number three, we got Aero / SNS 4D coasters, and Aero, you know, they built one, and then SNS picked up where they left off, and because they're 4D coaster, obviously they have the flipping, but combine that with the track just twisting and turning in every direction with the insane positives and whip, then you got yourself one crazy ride. It does not matter that these rides don't have great pacing or any airtime at all. What matters is that they're just super unique and bizarre, yet they're some of the craziest rides. I've heard that they are too much to handle for some people, and that's what I want. I want a ride that tries to kill you, and it seems like these 4D coasters do a very good job at that, so that's why they look like to be one of the best coaster models in the world. And number two, we have the RMC Hybrid Coasters. And there's been a lot of these, and I can see why parks love them. They're cheap, and you can take a old wooden coaster and make it one of the best coasters in the world. Like, just look at new for 2019, Hakugi. You know, that has 15 airtime moments, which is way more than the average coaster has. And all those moments are powerhouse ejector, some of them off-axis and sustained, others are like rapid fire pops and all this crazy stuff that we would never imagine just 10 years ago. But yeah, these coasters have it all, airtime wise, all different kinds of airtime, and they have lots of it to go around. Very compact layouts, and while some of them might not have great pacing, others do, and some of them might also bring some whip and some hang time to the table. Airtime in all different sorts and categories is the key feature for these coasters. And number one, we have the RMC T-Rex. You know, Tony Clark said that something is going to beat Steel Vengeance, and guess what? We have it now. The RMC T-Rex, you know, Theme Park Crazy interviewed that RMC guy, and he said that they could go over 500 feet, and that's what they were doing. Cedar Point 2020 or 2021, because they got it delayed. They are going to build a 500-foot-tall RMC T-Rex, and it's going to have the most airtime moment in the world, and it's going to have a 500-foot drop and crazy ejector and pacing. You know, we've seen the RMC Raptors, but this is just the bigger version of them, and is going to easily smash every single coaster that ever existed. But no, the RMC T-Rexes, that's just a fantasy for now, guys. You're going to have to still deal with the number one, the actual number one, the Intamin Giga Coasters. And Intamin has five spots in this list. Like, Intamin is too good, guys. They're just too good. But, you know, Intamin Gigas, they've only built two, but those are the two best coasters in the world, period. Destroy everything, do everything, and not only do they do everything good, do everything great. No, they do everything as best as possible. Sure, each one has a little bit of, like, flaws, but really nothing. They still absolutely destroy every single coaster out there. I-305 and Millie, some of the, they are the best coasters out there, but, you know, absolutely destroy every coaster. That is the best duo in the world. Mention any coaster, none even stand a chance against these coasters. They are too good, guys. They're too good to, like, exist. Like, they don't even seem real how good they are. But anyways, that's it for the video. Thanks for watching. Comment down below what you think about this list. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like, consider subscribing, and I'll see you guys later. Bye, everybody.